Let's configure RealtyJuggler for a large office. This configuration is suitable for a broker who wants to supervise several independent agents. If you are looking to share your RealtyJuggler database with a small team where you share the same calendar and same contacts, I recommend reviewing video tutorial 08 instead. Let's configure for a brokerage or large team. In this configuration, each agent has their own database, calendar, and contacts list. Individual agents can only see their own accounts, but the broker can oversee all of the agents and feed individual leads to specific agents. Additionally, each agent can synchronize their own contacts and calendar with their own smartphone, so this configuration allows for isolation of data from agent to agent. First, we need a free trial or a paid subscription for each agent, and one for the broker. To create the accounts, go to RealtyJuggler.com. Scroll down to the bottom and click on the yellow 90-day free trial button. I've already set up all the accounts I need, so I'll just sign into one of my agent's accounts, Tom@ElkRealty.com. I'll click on the settings icon and then on the sharing icon. I'll fill in the broker's email address, broker@ElkRealty.com, to give the broker full access to the agent's data. I'll click the Update button at the bottom of the screen to save the change. I have another agent that works for me that I also need to configure. I'll sign in to the second agent's account, Sally@ElkRealty.com. Click on Settings, and then on Sharing, and I'll add the broker's email, broker@ElkRealty.com, and click Update at the bottom of the screen. I can do the same thing with as many agents as I like. So if I had 20 agents working for me, I would sign into each agent's account and add in the broker's email address into the agent sharing screen. That allows the broker to access each of the 20 agents' databases. Now, let's sign in as the broker. When the broker signs in, they can access their own account or either of the agent's accounts using the Accessing drop-down menu in the upper right corner of the screen. I'll choose the broker's account, broker@ElkRealty.com. One common requirement is to assign leads that come into the broker's account to individual agents. The individual agents can only see the leads that have been assigned to them. I'll click on the prospects icon, and I can see that this lead, Jack Smith, just came in and has a category of Call Now. I'll click on the detailed view for this record and change the category from Call Now to Tom, as I intend to assign this lead to Tom. I'll click on the Transfer tab on the left and transfer a duplicate copy of the lead to Tom. Tom will get an email notifying them of the new lead, and I also keep a copy of the lead so I know who got assigned what lead. I can also supervise what Tom is doing with the lead. One of the easiest ways to do that is by selecting from the Accessing drop-down menu and then going into that prospect record and clicking on the Service Report tab on the left. I can then see all the activities that my agent has performed, all the phone calls, emails, printed letters, and other activities that they are doing to incubate this lead. For additional information on sharing, go back to the main screen and then click on the Video Tutorials icon. Next, scroll down past the Video Tutorials and then click on the Quick Start User's Manual. This manual has step-by-step instructions for sharing and also provides an overview of the functionality of RealtyJuggler.